Good morning. Bo, what is the equation for average velocity?
Flippin' physics.
Average velocity equals change in position over change in time.
Be aware, this is the equation for average linear velocity. Now let's introduce the equation for average angular velocity. The symbol for angular velocity is the lowercase Greek letter omega, which looks a lot like a curly W. Billy, what do you think the equation for average angular velocity is?
Well, average linear velocity equals the change in linear position over change in time, so average angular velocity must equal the change in angular position over change in time.
So average angular velocity equals change in theta or angular displacement over change in time.
Correct. Class, what are examples of units we could have for angular velocity?
Angular displacement over change in time. So, radians per second.
Revolutions per minute.
Degrees per decade.
Radians per century.
Degrees per decisecond.
That's right. There are all sorts of possibilities for the units for angular velocity. The two we will work with most often are radians per second and revolutions per minute. Radians per second are what we most commonly use in physics because radians have no units and are a placeholder. Revolutions per minute, or RPMs, are most commonly used in the real world. There are all sorts of objects which can have angular velocity. A bike tire, a record player, a power drill, a circular saw, a turning car, a ceiling fan. Even the engine of a car rotates with an angular velocity, and that is typically measured in revolutions per minute. And we determine the average angular velocity of all of these objects by using average angular velocity equals change in angular position over change in time.
Mr. Pete?
Yes, Bo?
What about the vector symbol over the velocities? You have not talked about direction at all.
Okay. So for a while, we will not discuss the direction of angular quantities like angular displacement and angular velocity. In my experience as a teacher, it is much easier for students to get to know the angular variables without direction first, and then introduce direction. Have patience. Direction will come soon enough. And for those of you who are not satisfied with that answer, understand that clockwise and counterclockwise are observer-dependent, and therefore we will be using what is called the right-hand rule instead of clockwise and counterclockwise. But not yet. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.